What's up, y'all? It's the Magi. It's time for another one. So today we're going to talk about Emperor Palpatine. And more specifically, this is an article from Screen Rant. And I won't put the thing inside the description, whatever. Just type in Screen Rant Palpatine and you'll get this article. And it's Star Wars reveals blank, spoiler, built the Empire, not Palpatine. So my question to Disney Lucasfilm is, who exactly are you marketing this franchise to? Who are you marketing it to? Because it seems that every time I turn around, you guys have some way, form, or fashion to dump on OG characters. Like, for real. Like, what is it in that mindset that you don't seem to get? Like, everything around you is crumbling. The Galaxy's Edge isn't popping. Your Star Wars Episode 9 excitement is not popping. Toys aren't popping. At some point, you can't sit there and keep saying, oh, it's incels in your mom's basement. It's just you freaking haters, you istophobes out there who just don't like our characters because they're this or that. At some point, you're going to have to say to yourself, what are we doing wrong? And I don't think you have the self-reflection to know what you're doing wrong. But before we get into what I see you doing wrong is, let's check out a quick paragraph out of that article there, because you got to get where this is coming from. So it says, every fan is going to want to know the woman born Patina Marvas Vore. 25 years before Sheev Palpatine began his rise to power, she married a lame-duck bureaucrat in the Empire's ruling class of competing officers and governors. You see, that's like an oxymoron, because if she married somebody 25 years prior to Palpatine's rise of power, there wasn't an empire of governors. It might have been a republic of governors, but not an empire of governors. I don't know. But anyway, Patina saw history repeating itself, that below all of the bravado, intimidation, and posturing, the expansion of the empire brought through brute force was killing it even as it spread, running out of both soldiers and money. And Patina just might have led the galactic empire to total success, if not one crucial weakness. Emperor Palpatine had absolutely no idea how to lead. So I'm going to take your Dr. Alpha Aphra, I messed that up, Aphra number 36, that's the comic book that this is coming from, it's a Marvel comic. I'm going to take your Marvel comic and I'm going to raise you a Darth Plagueis. You see, this right here is canon. I don't care what anybody says, this is canon, alright? And it's cool, I mean, when you look at the back, the excerpt from this is, Plagueis, in this right here, Plagueis was the most powerful Sith Lord who ever lived, but could he be the only one who ever died? Who never died, excuse me. So, listen, the thing that seems to be going way over Disney's head is that the grand plan was not just Palpatine's plan. It was something that existed for thousands of years, and the rule of two that got implemented by Darth Bane was what really set things in motion. And this is 1,000 years worth of planning, and of course, Sidious was the spear of that tip that basically toppled the Jedi. And Palpatine was cruel. He was ruthless and everything. And the way the story is put out is that this woman married a low-level governor. She convinced him to commit suicide and took his position. Which, you see, here's the thing, that while Disney tries to make this thing about, they twist things and make their all kinds of agenda. Listen, it's one thing if you can say, yeah, this was a woman who rose to power in the Galactic Empire. Which, again, by you doing this, you're getting rid of Natasi Dalia. And she's way, way more compelling than this woman here. Especially since this woman's being shoehorned in. You know, it's basically just being thrown in there and retconning Palpatine. You know what I'm saying? Because Palpatine was evil. Yes, he was evil because he had a family. And he 66'd them. You know, it was that was it. That was Palpatine was evil. He was evil. There's no doubt about that. But one thing he wasn't was just totally loose cannon. Because think about this, and this is using your brain. I know you guys don't do that much over there in Disney, but Palpatine had a Death Star, and without the whole six movies, the actual trilogy, the actual canon of Star Wars to me, George's, and he only used Death Star once. The Death Star was only used once on Alderaan. You know what it is? Because even Palpatine told Vader, and I forget which novel it was, but he told him, I want to be the ruler of the galaxy, not the ruler of the dead. So, yes, he was brutal, but he was very tactical with what he did. And the point of him having the Death Star was to use fear and intimidation. And that's what the Sith use a lot. So by them destroying Alderaan, the reason why he destroyed Alderaan, because that was basically where Bail Organa, who was one of the main leaders of the rebellion. And so that was eliminate him, you basically eliminate, you know, a good portion of the rebellion. You know what I'm saying? So that was one of the reasons why I did it, because if you just goes around destroying everything, which, wait a minute, who did that? That's right, the First Order. First Order destroyed several Republic planets. Like, so you're gonna say Palpatine was more of a loose cannon, that he was didn't have a plan, that this unknown person had to come in there and basically guide him? Because first off, Palpatine would, let's be clear, women in the Galactic Empire didn't really happen that much. So by them saying, I guess they're trying to replace her with Dahlia, I'm mispronouncing that word. Maybe that's what they're trying to do, but this character that they're creating is undermining what Sidious was doing in his plan. Because if you're going to say that he basically just not a good leader, I find that very hard to believe, being that he did what he had to do for a very long time. Because remember, this is all planning, especially when you read this book. This stuff was going on way before he rose into power, obviously. So he was already part of a ruling class family. He was part of an elite family to begin with. Palpatine was. So it wasn't like he wasn't versed in political standings and all that stuff like that. So by you sit there and then saying that he didn't know how to lead was insulting to the fans who enjoyed his canon. It's insulting. Because Palpatine was very clever and he was very cunning at that. So, again, my question is, who are you marketing this franchise to? Because you can't sit there and say you're marketing it to kids when you're doing stuff like having, you know, same team player relationships in cartoons, and they say, oh, it's a kid show. Why would you put that in for a kid show? You can't say, again, it's for kids if you go by old school stuff and they're, you know, cutting off limbs and beheading people. And then at the same time, you're dumping on the fans who made this franchise where it is. Because if it wasn't for people like myself, there would be no Disney Lucasfilm, because nobody would be buying into it. But I think that's kind of what you're going for, is trying to get nobody buying into it. Because just like I said at the beginning of this video, everything's down. Your hype for your movies is down. The toys aren't selling. I'm pretty sure nobody's going to... The only reason I'm talking about this is because I have to, again, my job is to bounce that nonsense back. That's what my job is for. You put nonsense out there, I got to bounce it back. It's like playing tennis. Bounce it back to you, because this is nonsense, okay? So, I don't know what to say. It's just annoyed me so much that, you know, you guys are dumping on one of my favorite villains out there. You know, it's very few villains that really stand out to me, and, you know, Palpatine is one of them. Obviously, everybody loves Vader, but we want to think about somebody who's manipulative, who's cunning, vicious. It is Palpatine. Vader, yes, he was like that, but he was more like a weapon than anything else. I mean, think about it. When you look at even like the Revenge of the Sith, Palpatine used him as a tool to get rid of the Jedi. It was all Palpatine's plan to get rid of the Jedi. Yes, he taught Anakin Sith, you know, training and all that stuff like that. But, you know, once he got maimed, him becoming the master was really cut down considerably, being that he was so mechanical. He needed to have more organic parts, so to say, to become the master of the Sith. So, but there's that. And again, I'm just confused at what you guys are trying to do. I mean, because there's no way you're going to tell me that by undermining Palpatine, by doing what you're doing. Look, and again, there's one thing you could say, that the woman rose to power and everything like that. She has some back-end deals or whatever. But don't sit there and try to insult us and say she was the one who was doing all this grand planning. Because Sidious was very calculating with planning and everything. Like, if you even read this book, if you actually read this book, he basically played out Plagueis, if you read this book. But then again, I'm pretty sure you guys don't read those books because you're just making up your own can anyway, because you just disavow these books anyway. So I'll just disavow your books. Simple. We balance each other out. We disavow our books, we disavow your books. Plain and simple. But anyway, how do you guys feel about this Dr. Aphra. That name. Aphra. Whatever. How do you feel about this comic? Do you think it's insulting to, you know, good old-fashioned Darth Plagueis novels? I think it is. Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit that notification bell so you get my videos when I drop. I'll catch y'all later. Peace. Physical.